This video will demonstrate how to install the Leviton IPVD6 Vacancy Sensor with Dimmer and IPSD6 Occupancy Sensor with Dimmer. Please be certain to follow all wiring instructions and diagrams provided with these products. If you're unsure about any part of the instructions, or if you're not comfortable or familiar with working with electrical wiring, contact an electrician. When installing and terminating these Leviton devices, have the following tools on hand: a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, a mini flathead screwdriver, electrician's pliers, a wire stripper, electrical tape, and a handheld voltage tester. This installation takes approximately 15 minutes. The process shown follows general guidelines. Local codes take precedence. Be sure to turn the power off at the circuit breaker and use a voltage tester to ensure that the power is completely off. Now, we need to identify the hot wire. To do this, turn the circuit breaker back on. Carefully use the voltage tester to test each wire. The hot wire will be indicated by the tester. Once identified, turn off the circuit breaker to shut power and test to ensure that the power is off. Use a small piece of electrical tape to label the hot wire. These devices offer the option of either wrapping leads around the terminal screws or using an external backwire clamp. We're going to demonstrate backwiring. Note, a neutral is not required for this installation. In this example, in the wall box, there is one black wire which is the hot, a bare copper wire which is the ground, and a black wire which is the load wire. Keep in mind, the color of the wires can vary. The hot wire may be black or red. The ground wire could be green or bare copper. If you're unsure, contact an electrician. Next, you need to be sure that the wires are prepared for installation. Start by making sure the wires are straight and stripped according to the strip gauge located on the back of the device. To wire, connect the load wall box wire to terminal screw marked RD. Connect the line hot wall box wire to the terminal screw marked BK. Connect the green or bare copper wire in the wall box to the green terminal screw. The device is now terminated. Position all wires to provide room in the outlet wall box for the device. Ensure that the word top is facing up on the device. Partially screw in the mounting screws in the wall box mounting holes. We will now test the device prior to mounting in the wall box. First, we will adjust timeout and light sensitivity levels. Remove the face cover of the sensor to expose the adjustment dials. Set time selection of the sensor to 30 seconds for a quick timeout during testing. Set the light level dial full clockwise. Place the face cover back on the sensor. Restore power at circuit breaker or fuse. For IPSD6, lights will automatically turn on after power is applied because it is an occupancy sensor. This means the device automatically turns the lights on when motion is detected and automatically turns the lights off when motion is no longer detected. For IPVD6, which is a vacancy sensor, you will press and release push pad to turn the lights on. As a vacancy sensor, lights must be manually turned on, but will automatically turn off when the room is vacant and motion is no longer detected. Note, if lights do not turn on, refer to the troubleshooting section of the instruction sheet. Leave the room or field of view to allow the sensor to time out and shut off the lights due to the absence of motion. Within 30 seconds of the lights timing out, step back into the room or field of view of the sensor, and the lights should turn back on automatically. Set time selection. This is the amount of time the lights will stay on before turning off after no motion is detected. Set the light level. Note that at higher sensitivity, the lights will turn on in lighter conditions, such as a sun-filled room. If you reduce the sensitivity, the sensor will not turn on when there is significant ambient light. Vacancy sensors are manual on, so sensitivity does not apply. Set the CFL LED dimming. The dimmer features a user-adjustable dial for setting the minimum light level. This feature can be used with certain lighting loads to reduce any flicker at low light levels. When the desired light level, time selection, and sensitivity settings are selected, place the face cover back on the sensor. Turn power off at the circuit breaker. Tighten the mounting screws into the wall box. Attach wall plate. Restore power at the circuit breaker. Your Leviton IPVD6 vacancy sensor with dimmer and IPSD6 occupancy sensor with dimmer are now ready for use. For more information about the IPVD6 vacancy sensor with dimmer and IPSD6 occupancy sensor with dimmer from Leviton, visit leviton.com/sensors.